All right, aftermath, run number three on the brick Taurus. Hoo boy, a lot to say about this. Trying to figure out the best way to put it into words for you guys. So this was a complete weird run for this car, but also it was a very weird derby the entire night. So I need to put a little bit of pretext into this, but I don't want to call out names, so we're going to keep it very simple to let you guys know what went down. There was a fire department for the show that was in charge of watering the track for this derby. For whatever reason, I don't know. I don't know who said what to who. The fire department took it upon themselves to determine how much water they were going to put on the track without anyone else controlling them to stop it. After two full tanker trucks of water, they decided to bring out a third tanker truck, and this is not fireman hoses. This is opening a valve and flooding the entire side of the truck onto the track. There was a huge argument. Many words were exchanged between promoters, fair boards, fire departments, and police officers between that entire fiasco. Basically, the track was a swamp. It was over a foot deep of pure liquid mud, as you can see right here, absolutely ruined by that fire department. Again, not going to say names, not going to be involved, just giving you the info of what went down that we witnessed and heard. What happened after that is, I don't know if it was a pride issue, I don't know if they were just butthurt and angry or whatever, the fire department did not place fire personnel around the arena. They only would sit back at the trucks and only stood in one corner of the track for the beginning of the derby. This caused a major issue if somebody were to catch on fire, if there would be liabilities, somebody could be maimed and seriously injured and the fire personnel not doing their actual job they're required to do, protect and serve. So other fire departments were called in to replace them. The police had to escort that existing fire department off the track and the derby could resume. That delayed the entire show. They tried to scrape the track. As you can tell by the massive amount of mud, it was not possible. So yes, we filmed the entire event. I apologize to any of you guys that have watched the videos. I apologize to all the drivers that attended the show, and I apologize to the promoter that tried so hard to have a good fall show for us at this event. All of that was beyond our control once the track was that deep of mud. It absolutely ruined the night. You will see it in the heats. Every car was buried in the mud. Every car was wide open on the throttle. Engines blowing, transmissions blowing, tires popping, and you were sitting still in the mud once you had one flat. With that being said, let's move on from that and talk about this car. Going out there, you guys saw our live feed, you saw my video of getting ready to put this car on the trailer for the derby. What is one thing we did? Well, we put tiny little tires on the back of this car. Because this had been packing in, we wanted all the wheel clearance in the world to help us. 95% of derbies, that would have been okay. But with the deep, deep mud that unfortunately plagued this event, that was the wrong idea. Driving out there immediately, any car that had tiny little tires or any car that was pre-bent and damaged in the rear, the entire back of this car buried itself in the mud. As you can see, it is all the way up, deep, deep into the base of that spindle and strut. I cannot even see the spindle on the back of this car, is how deep it has gone. It was so bad, in fact, that during the derby, I actually thought Susan had popped this donut tire and the tire was sideways wrapped around the rim, only to realize at the end of the derby, the tire was fine and it was just so much mud wrapped around there, this wheel was locking up, it wouldn't turn, it bound up. On top of that, several cars, including this one, were actually damaging their own steering because of the thickness and weight of the mud was building up underneath inside of here. That's what seemed to have helped contribute to this vehicle here. It was so buried by the end of the derby, I could not even see the CV axle or tie rod on this side of the car. You can see how deep everything is buried up in there. So Susan went out there, tried to use this car, tried to do what she could with it. It was absolutely dragging in the back from the get-go. It was wide open throttle to get it to move in the mud. Every time you aimed at cars, you're sliding, you had no steering, so when you turned your steering wheel, the car would just keep sliding in other directions. It was a mess. Couple cars got lucky enough to get some traction from one end to the other, getting the entire length of the track to make a good decent, somewhat hit. What happened to this car is still a major mystery. We have got a lot to figure out on this. So something let go very early on. Now, I have not watched my GoPro yet. We did run a GoPro on this. At this point, I'm assuming when you guys are watching my aftermath video, I've already put the GoPro online, but right now at the moment of me filming this, I've not seen it. Hopefully I can diag what happened to the, I'm gonna say cooling system, I don't know. Something popped, something blew smoke everywhere under the hood. On a very minor hit, Susan used the corner of this bumper and hit a car, and then everything was just white and everything immediately started overheating. I don't know if there's a hose somewhere, a cracked block, a freeze plug, or worse, that had happened to it. But from that point on, it immediately lost all water. And with it being such deep mud, you had to run the throttle wide open to continue moving in the mud. So as you guessed it, every engine overheated twice as fast when you're doing that. One thing I am concerned about, which happened way too fast, remember how we had pulled this frame rail back sideways? Remember how it was hitting the pulleys? Well, just that one hit, and that wasn't even a hard shot, but that one hit to this corner of the frame immediately blew the side of that frame right back out, chewed it into the pulleys. Unfortunately, it did get a hold of the pulley on the water pump. It has disintegrated the entire outer ring of that pulley. See the lip right there on the back? That lip is gone. It has shattered it off. The belt's disintegrated where it chewed through it. Potentially, the water pump could be junk after the frame smacked that pulley. That could have been what happened on this corner shot. From that point on, maybe we had zero water pump and it just overheated, or we dumped all the coolant out of a cracked water pump. There is a chance if I get back in there, maybe the housing to the water pump let go. I don't know. We also could have some lines on the back of the motor that are giving us an issue. The easiest way to figure this out is I'm going to get this back in the shop and we are going to refill the entire coolant system back to the top, start the car up, and basically find the leak. Somewhere it's going to pour out. I don't know where. On top of that, we did have a fire. I am going to guess it was power steering related. I can't guarantee. We may have also lost a seal up here and had oil coming out. I'm not sure. It had an aftermarket seal, which was a decent one right there. You can see the bit of blue poking out. Maybe a bunch of oil leaked out of the valve cover and caught on fire. Or we do have a major failing steering system on this car. So the power steering pump is going out. It does have a leak. It whines really bad. There's air in the system. The rack is got some serious damage from the last run. It is super, super loose. It clicks and knocks, and when you turn the steering wheel, there is slop in the steering wheel like crazy. So it is basically to the point where it's almost unusable for steering at this point. So I'm wondering if the power steering fluid did not back up, overflow, or just leak and rupture onto this exhaust and cause a small fire. In doing so, it did manage to burn this spark plug. It also managed to burn this spark plug, and for some reason, this one is not connected anymore, so it has come off the motor. I'm assuming from the fire. I don't know how else it could have became disconnected from such a basic run in the mud. Again, no hard, heavy head-on shots were possible in this derby, but this one here is also a little bit cooked, as you can see by the burn marks on that. So the entire front of this flared up. It wasn't a long fire, but it is enough. Sometimes you can lose, again, your ignition system by doing that. So with that being a culprit also fighting this car, we were down a cylinder, we were overheated, no coolant. I don't know. A lot of things went wrong really quick on this vehicle. And as we've been saying, we had an amazing year. We were due for some bad derby luck, and this definitely showed its face this time around in the arena. Other than that, what else has gone wrong? Somehow our cap has blown off the filler neck because it was threaded on tight. There was a nice shot that caught this fender, as you can see here. It has blown in, potentially crushing that cap. Maybe it just blew the threads, peeled it open. Maybe this tank has ruptured somewhere. I don't know. I can't find cracks anywhere of that either. So a lot of digging around to do to try and figure this out. Moving on away from the front and what's unknown happening there. There is a steering issue on this wheel. When they pulled it out of the track, I thought for sure the tie rod was snapped in half, because this wheel was hanging way out here while the other one was only half turned in. So this one has twice the turn radius. The car refired once it had cooled down and the derby was over. I turned the steering wheel and boom, the wheel popped back straight. So something is functioning in the steering box to an extent, but it is very far stretched, because a dead giveaway, if you guys ever want to know, if you have steering issues starting to happen, look at your tread and look at the inside of your frame. You see in here? There's really shiny metal on my motor mount. There's really shiny metal on the bolts. That would be this tire chewing the tread as you turn all the way in there and catch on all that metal. This tire should not be hitting those components. So that means something's bent to the point where this tire is turning extremely hard and extra sharp in those directions. Once we get all this mud knocked off, I can really dig into it more, see what's happening. I just can't get a good visual right now. It does run, it does drive. We got it up on the trailer. I did not know it was running on 5 cylinders when we put it on the trailer last night. So, surprising, it was still running as good as it was. With that being said, the back, virtually untouched. I think it took one hit on this thing. Everything else is about the exact same as when you guys saw it, just to the nature of the show not giving a hard enough shot to really cause much damage. I think the only noticeable damage that's worth mentioning would be this door finally took a decent hit to the passenger door, and it pushed it in to the dash, but not to the seat yet. Remember, this is only a seat bar vehicle, no full cage in this mobile. So let me go ahead and throw the battery on. I'm gonna show you guys starting this thing real quick. See how it runs. Remember, it's still unplugged on 5 cylinders. I want to see the noise it makes and see if that sounds the same as when it did last night. Or maybe the spark plug was just melted and hot, and on the road home, hitting potholes, it worked itself loose. Ouch. So there we go, battery's on. Let's reach in here and just give her a bump. Strangely, the pulley is not rubbing the frame right now. It broke off all the bit of pulley that was touching. So let's see here, get our power on. So there it is running. So that's running on 5 cylinders, and honestly, it's not that noticeable to the ear that it's on 5 cylinders. And that is exactly how it sounded last night when I loaded it. So I'm going to assume it was on 5 cylinders for a good while in the derby itself. You see the pulleys there, the belt is really rough looking. Good news is the pulleys are not wobbling left and right. They're all straight. So that's a good sign the shaft has not bent or broke, if possible, on this thing. Other than that, I don't see any major fluid leaks just while it's sitting here in the daylight. Again, the coolant system's empty, so can't really judge that. We're just gonna have to get this thing heated up and judge it from there, I suppose. Yeah, let me turn this back off because we're running without water. So let's plug that other boot on, and let's see if that spark plug is even still working. If the boot still has a good enough connection, it is melted. So let's... Boy, doesn't want to fit on. I think the inside has cooked itself on that boot. Yep, I think it is almost done. It has melted all the way through the side of that boot. I've plugged it in, but there's no guarantee it's going to make a difference. I'm curious. I want to crank it again. Let's start it. I want to see... if I can hear anything different in the engine with all 6 turned back on, if it's even working, I don't know. All right, here we go. Oh yeah, there's a difference. It's working. I can tell. I don't know if you guys can tell. It's better. So now, previously the motor was shaking just a little bit when it was running. Now this motor is completely smooth. You don't see it shaking on the motor mounts. You don't see any of the top side of the engine have a vibration. With 5 cylinders, it was doing a little bit of this number. Hey, you can see the stumble, essentially. So that spark plug is still working. The boot is junk, but enough to get a spark on it right now. That's good. I can get it drove off with all 6 cylinders. Cool. All right, turn all that back off. That is my very quick self-diagnosis of a few issues. stay tuned. I'm going to get this off the trailer, get it in the shop. If I can figure out what happened to it, we will give you guys another update video. As for the future of this car, always a question to debate. Everybody wants to know, will it run again? Is it junk? We are approaching very quickly the end of Derby season. With that being said, we have to judge which cars to keep, which cars not to keep. And with this frame having kicked, I really wish you guys could see back in there how bad that side has bent. So with it eating the pulleys off the side of this motor, we may just call it for this car, to be honest. We may save this engine. It's a really good runner. It hasn't been trashed yet. It hasn't blown up. Obviously, if we keep doing what we're doing, we're going to blow it up on those pulleys. We may just put this in one of our other Taurus or Sable vehicles that we have that have bad engines, or buy one junk with a bad engine and drop this in there. I've always wanted to do that. We've never done it on the channel. This could be a good chance for that. We also have the wagon that has a good 3.0 engine. So we now have two good 3.0 Ford engines with keys, with the computers, with the factory column ignition, all that stuff, everything we can use to transfer over. We might mess around a bit with that. If we do that, I will make a whole video series of pulling all of this out of this car. We will drop the subframe motor wiring. And when we do that, that means I can show you guys how bad the frame is damaged with this motor removed from the vehicle. So there you have it. Thanks for tagging along on our journey with the brick Taurus. Bit of a letdown for the final run, but that is the nature of the game. Stay tuned. We will update you if there are going to be any more runs this year. Again, that's going to depend on weather and wrapping up the end of the season. So catch you guys in the next video.